Modern internet was born almost exactly 25 years ago with the creation in the United States of the first modern web browsers, namely Mosaic and Netscape Navigator. This began the era of the first internet boom with companies such as AOL and Yahoo. What made this first internet boom possible was a visionary policy decision by the administration of President Bill Clinton to create regulatory environment which came to be known by two principles: light touch and safe harbor. This very relaxed and welcoming regulatory environment first prevented excessive government interference too early in the process of innovation. Second, give innovator the confidence to experiment without having to fear civil or criminal liability if their experiment fail. As a result, innovation flourished, creating not only great wealth and many economic benefits, but also laying the foundations for the modern internet of today. Today, we are again in the midst of another great flowering of internet-based innovation. And more dramatically, today's internet boom is reaching deep into the foundation of the economy, into the very payment that are the lifeblood of daily commerce. PayPal, Apple Pay, Alipay, WeChat Pay, and many other such innovations are transforming daily life for hundreds of millions of people around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, similar to the original internet boom 25 years ago, we should not trust to regulate these new innovations, but should allow innovation and experimentation to flourish first. That means we should once again approach this big wave of innovation with light touch regulation. And we should provide safe harbor to those inventors and entrepreneurs who are bringing radical new tools to society. Innovation comes from experimentation, and many or even most experiments fail. That is the nature of experiment. To punish failure is to discourage experiments. And without experiment, there simply cannot be innovation. Therefore, it would be contradictory to talk about wanting innovation, but then to punish failure excessively.
Please kindly smile.